month ago when Log4Shell first flooded the media, I was in roughly the same boat as everybody else on the internet. Who is vulnerable? Well, how does it work? When will it be fixed? And how do I guard my system? It soon became apparent that this was largely a server-side issue, and all end users had to worry about was whether or not applications on their computer ran the Log4j service. For many of us, that happens to be Minecraft. It wasn't long before I came across the info on Minecraft.net explaining that Log4Shell had already been fixed in Minecraft version 1.18.1. It would seem that all there was left to do was update Minecraft from version 1.18.0 to 1.18.1, and the problem would be resolved. I stopped worrying about it too much after that, but a few days ago when I started picking up Java again for myself, all that began to change as I was forced to understand all this inside and out. For those who don't know what Log4Shell is, well, hopefully you do, because it's flaming hot cybersecurity news right now. Log4Shell is a zero-day exploit found in a highly common Java library called Log4j. Zero-day means hackers know about it long before the general public. Log4Shell is similar in some ways to an SQL injection. This is basically where a hacker finds a loophole to run malicious code on your machine, and from there they can take over your whole computer. The Log4j library is quite ubiquitous. It's frequently packaged with applications and bundled with all kinds of services around the web. After all, Java is the number one development platform, right? So the saying goes. You've probably seen the familiar 3 billion devices run Java screen if you've ever installed JRE. This plugin is everywhere, including, you guessed it, yours truly. Minecraft started using this library around version 1.8. That was 2014. The absurdity that no one has noticed this critical flaw for almost 9 years is part of what makes it such big news. With an open source project like Log4j, anybody can sit down and have a look at the source code and make improvements for themselves, security ones included. But the question is, do they? Normally, we place faith in open source projects like these. Is that all about to change? Well, only time will tell, but no doubt Log4Shell will send ripples throughout the open source community for years. This whole fiasco was disclosed on December 10th, and Minecraft released their 1.18.1 update to address it that same day. Now that's fine, but there's a problem. Multiple new vulnerabilities have been discovered since then, and here we are just waiting for a 1.18.2 to see if they'll be fixed too. And so far it hasn't happened. To put it lightly, the issue has evolved quite a bit since it appeared, and what started as one hack has now turned into 4 different exploits. We call them attack vectors in the cyber world. And to cover these different vectors, the devs have had to release different updates. Of these 4 vulnerabilities, 2 of them still affect Minecraft 1.18.1. So even though Mojang may have claimed to offer us a solution, they haven't seemed to fall in step with Apache's official recommendations. The landing page for Log4j clearly explains that all versions prior to 2.17.1 are affected by more recent vulnerabilities which have been discovered and disclosed. Right now, this is a topic of controversy, and I've had an interesting discussion with folks in the Minecraft community about it online. Some people seem to have their own ideas about this, but I hate to say that I think I'll be uninstalling Minecraft for the time being, just until Mojang gets on board with the newer Log4j updates. Now, some will make the argument that Apache's claims are unreliable, and it's only a matter of time before the latest update is found to be vulnerable again. Now, this is probably true, but even if this happens, no amount of modding can change the fact that Apache is the vendor. They're the ones responsible for user awareness of flaws in their products and their eventual correction. Mojang has seemed to overlook this to some extent, creating their own modified version of Log4j, which used to satisfy Apache guidelines, but hasn't now for a long time. Look at it this way. When you modify Minecraft yourself, you can add as much as you want, but at some point, we still rely on Mojang for the official changes. It's the same when Minecraft modifies Log4j. Now that's the thing. There was always the possibility of updating the logger manually, but as it stands today, if you try to edit or delete Log4j in Minecraft 1.18.1, then the Minecraft launcher might just roll back the changes on you. So for now, seems the only option is taking a break. If there are any traces of Log4j on your system, they should be up to date, otherwise you might be vulnerable. Keep JRE uninstalled unless absolutely necessary. And I'm not saying that just because of Log4Shell. JRE on its own isn't even vulnerable to Log4Shell. I'm saying it anyway. Java has had a long history of posing security issues for users. There is a reason it's been through so many versions. If you are using mods, then you need it. But if you are just playing vanilla, don't install it. Now, even without Java, you could still be vulnerable. Run a system-wide search for files of interest. For this type of thing, I recommend the Everything app. It's very fast and lightweight, plus it's easy to use. My coworker introduced me to this program a few years ago. Use it to search for Log4j and find out how many programs you have that use it. If your Log4j version is 2.15 or less, the folder you are looking for is Log4j-core. This is the exploitable one. So what would happen if you were to use Minecraft's 1.18.1 patch as is? Well, according to public records, Log4j 2.14.1 is still susceptible to a denial of service attack. And no, this wasn't patched in Minecraft 1.18.1, seeing as it was announced after the release of 1.18.1. Denial of service means your computer could get flooded with information and eventually crash. This is not such a huge deal if you have a great backup system, but it's still not fun or worth it just for one program. What is a big deal is the flaw that was disclosed more recently on December 28th, which the Log4j website derives most of its mitigation details from. This most recent hole is also a remote code execution vulnerability, the same kind as the one originally announced on December 10th. No, it hasn't been assigned the same severity level, but just to know it's there is enough to make your butt cheeks tighten, so let's all do ourselves a favor and just take a break for a while, shall we? Maybe eventually Mojang will notice and see that they need to get the ball rolling with version 2.17.1 or whatever Apache's next release will be. And then Minecraft can go back to being the blissful, better-than-life experience that it is. If you guys found this information helpful, go spread it everywhere you can, because less crashing and more gaming is what we want for you guys. So do the right thing and stay safe out there. Keep your data secure. Always back up everything. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Bye now!